You know, Uranium Bicycle defined music in the 90s, and then flipped it around and redefined it.
I learned English by listening to Uranium Bicycle.
Uranium Bicycle, I think they really have it down. With those hats, whoever got that, they're just hot. And I have one thing to say, and that is Kyle's glasses, hot. Hot.
Whenever I'm feeling kind of down and depressed, I just go into my room, turn on a Uranium Bicycle CD, and just kind of chill out. I mean, like, the music just really speaks to me as a person.
Alright, if you think Uranium Bicycle is huge in the United States, I've been to Australia, and I can tell you, it's practically like a religion over there.
One, two, three, four! I play my drum for him, pa rum pa pom pom. Me and my drum.
Here we see Australian legends Uranium Bicycle nearly 1 year after the incident that many thought would be the end of their reign over the children's soft rock circuit. They are hard at work on making their Christmas album in an attempt to rebuild the dynasty they once possessed. The band you see and hear now bears little resemblance to the young men who met in a bar in Melbourne, Australia back in the early 90s. They are older and wiser now. But what turns did their road to stardom take that led them to this fate? In the next 10 minutes, we will examine the triumphs and tribulations of Uranium Bicycle.
I'm a rich Texan who makes tons of foolish purchases. And one time when I went to Melbourne, Australia, I heard this Uranium Bicycle band, and ooh-wee, that was some type of music. Kids in the U.S. if they needed to hear this type of music.
You know, we met in a bar in Melbourne, and, you know, we decided to make it a reenactment, so we hired an actor, Asian sensation John Dang.
This song is really great.
Yeah, you know, we could do something like this.
Yeah, let's start a band.
Crikey, let's do it.
What will we be called?
Uranium?
Bicycle!
But wait, we need a third person, preferably a keyboardist.
Hey mates. I'm from America, and I play the keyboards. Can I be in the band?
I don't see why not.
Sure.
Right, that's pretty much how it happened, alright?
One member of the band quickly distinguished himself with his high-flying antics.
Part of his genius is that he never moves. I mean, you know, he just stand there, and, you know, he just, like, one key, and he, you know, you just get this wall of sound, you know. Plethora of notes and melodies and music, it's genius. I'm telling you, mate, it's genius.
So a lot of people ask me about the hat, right? And what I tell them is, the hat is everything.
Excuse me, man, just getting some milk. Some snacks. What, are you making a dating tape?
It's a documentary, man. Remember? The documentary?
Yeah, just keep telling yourself that.
Right. Anyways, the hat. This is my livelihood right here. Without this, I'd be a surfing bum.
Just gotta put the milk back in the fridge, you know. Keep it cold.
Right, it's alright, man. All right. Anyways, the hat.
So when I was a little one, my gram gave me this hat, you see, and so, you know, she said, if you always wear this, I will always be with you. I'll be inside of you. And so that's why I always wear this hat, because, you know, it's just remembering me gram.
Bob! Where's your hat, Bob? I'll tell you where your hat is. It's not on your head. We bought you this hat so that you could wear it on your head. And where do I find the hat? I found it in your closet. It's nowhere near your head. It's in your bloody closet. Are you listening to me?
Sorry, man, did you say something?
Turn off the camera. Turn it off.
Oh. Yeah, my hat has no significant value at all. I don't like it. They just gave it to me the first day I joined. I don't like to wear it, but Kyle seems kind of anal about hats. I don't know what it is.
Mate, I'm right here.
Look, I am not some monkey in your circus, Kyle.
The boys found the music industry to be rough and were soon strapped for cash.
I knew the boys needed to get their name out there in America, so I got them a commercial for the Outback Steakhouse.
I don't know about these American beaches, Kyle.
Yeah, I know. It's freaking cold. These Americans, they just didn't know what they're doing with beaches.
But they did get one thing right.
The Outback Steakhouse.
The food's great.
And the service, too. But don't take it from us.
Just ask our American friend.
He'll tell you the Outback Steakhouse is a great place to eat.
Outback Steakhouse. No rules. Just right.
They even have curbside takeaway. Looks like they've outdone us Aussies.
Come on over to our house, the Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
With the success of the commercial, they were rolling in the dough.
This is not plugged in. I need power.
We'll just stand there and look pretty then.
Besides, it's unplugged. Knock MTV unplugged.
Yeah, but they've never done keyboard unplugged.
Well, you could just stand there then and, you know, do something edgy, okay? In the next set, alright? Alright, first off, we're gonna, let's get this show on the road. Good morning, Whitefish Bay. Are you ready for some music? Cause it's time for some music right here. This one's out for all you people who like peanuts. Do you know what peanuts are? They're those little nuts that you crack open and you eat. And the guy that the dark bloke like invented them, that George Washington Carver, right? Alright. Anyway, here's the song. A one, a two, a one, two, three, four. I like peanuts, yes I do. I like peanuts, so do you. I like peanuts. I like peanuts! Yeah! Whitefish Bay, are you ready to rock? Right now, we got this song that Neil Young wrote and that I think maybe David Hasselhoff might have performed that one time at the Berlin Wall. And we're gonna perform it right here. Right now, for you, at the Whitefish Bay Wall. One, a two, one, two, three, four. Keep on rocking in the free world. Keep on rocking in the free. Oh!
Crikey.
The wall incident, yeah. You know, Kyle said to do something edgy, and I thought, you know, climbing the wall.
That's a start, you know, but it was a little tough to climb. It's a bit cold. Lost my grip and I fell, and I kind of hurt my arm, but mostly just hurt my ego. And then Kyle swore, you know, into the mic, which, you know, that's not good at a children's concert. And it was downhill from there.
Yes, it was indeed downhill. But with their upcoming Christmas album, they have a chance at redemption. Shawshank Redemption. Carry on, my wayward sons. There'll be peace when you are done.
Look, I am not some monkey in your circus, Kyle.
I'll be inside of you, Jim John Dang.
I've been to Australia.